Starting off as usual with the introduction of the beer. This is Java the Stout from Black Wheat Brewing in Brandon, Manitoba. They describe it as a creamy sweet stout with rich cold brew coffee character and chocolate notes from the malt. So today I'm looking at this APC branded power strip with surge suppression and built-in USB charging. As opposed to the usual cheap Chinese crap that I get around here, this is actually from a known brand. I mean, anybody who's dealt with surge suppression or desk side UPSs probably recognizes who APC is. So when I found this at a yard sale for less than a dollar, obviously I had to grab it. If it works, it's an awesome deal, and if it doesn't work, it's going to make a fine video. It's got a proper UL listing on it. That's good to see. It is rated for 120 volts, 12 amps, 60 hertz, which is fairly standard for this kind of thing. Plus, the USB outputs are rated for 2.1 amps total. So I'm assuming that's across the three outputs. The voltage protection, line to neutral, line to ground, and neutral to ground are all 400 volts. So I'm assuming that there's probably going to be 400 volt MOVs in here protecting that to clamp the higher voltage. And all the rest of this, do not plug into another power strip. Good, it doesn't say do not open. And even if it did, that wasn't going to slow me down.
See if we can find any more information on the manufacturer's website. The first and obvious thing that I notice is that. So if it works, excellent deal. Down here, all the same specs as we saw on the back of it. Oh, there's a user guide. I don't know how much user guide you actually need, but plug it in, verify the safety of the building wiring. Yeah, whatever. So there's two indicators on it, protection working indicator LED and a ground OK. So that will be basically making sure that there is voltage from between ground and live and that there is not voltage between ground and neutral, as it should be. And here is all the same specs on the back that we saw on the back of it. Okay, not much information there other than telling us what those indicators mean.
Cool. Maybe I should plug it in and see if those indicators actually work before I get too much further down this road. Yep, they both seem to. That's cool. So next, I think I'm going to simulate a miswiring using this little dangerous thing that should not exist. I've got the hot and neutral or line and neutral swapped on this little guy. So we'll plug that in. And yeah, it is indicating that the ground is in fact not okay. So what's next for this thing? Maybe we test the USBs before we get carried away here? Sure, let's do that. So I've got my USB load connected to my USB meter here. Oh wow, those are very tight. I don't know that those have been used very much. Those are really tight. Okay. Anyway, we have 5 volts, 5.08 volts reading and half an amp. I'll just turn up the load here. There's 1 amp, still solid at 5 volts, 5.07 volts. I'm just going to keep cranking that up off screen. You can see what's happening here. 1.3 amps, still holding fairly steady. 1.36, 1.4, 1.5, what did it say? 2.1. There's 2 amps and it's still solid at 5.02 volts. So 2.1 was the threshold the manual gave. Still good there. 2.2, 2.25 amps. That's excellent. A cheap Chinese one would have cratered long ago. Oh, there it goes. Just turn back down and see where that died. So somewhere between 2.25 and 2.3, which is well over the rating for it. Yeah, there it goes. Okay, that's excellent. Exactly what I would expect from a reputable brand like that. You may have noticed that this one has a slightly different marking on it. That is also a very cool feature. that allows you to plug a wall wart in and still have these two available for plugging stuff in. Because you've seen this problem before on power bars where you plug a wall wart in and then you just cannot plug anything else in, right? So that is a nice feature. And of course, this slot here is for exactly this purpose. Just setting your phone in there. Not that that's really a surprise. I'm sure you've seen that on lots of devices before. But none of that is why we're here today. So let us do the deed that we were all planning. There's two visible screws there, which are clearly clamping the cable. And then we have four little feet here. I'm going to guess that underneath them is, yep, hidden screws. Oh, not just screws, but security one-way screws. Oh, this is going to be interesting. So there's three of those screws in these three corners. This corner was obviously just held together with that. So now I've got to figure out how to get these one-way screws out. I'm not sure if I have bits for that. I have lots of security type bits, but I don't know that any of those are... Yeah, well, I mean, we'll try, but I may be disappointed here. This sucks. Oh, no. It'll come. You just have to really push against it while you're twisting. Okay. They're a suggestion of deterrent rather than actually stopping a determined fool like me from opening up a mains-powered device. It's got to put lots of downward pressure. Okay. So now then, we just pry? How do we get in here? How does this work? What are you doing? I suppose a spudger would be the proper tool for this job. Okay, man. Yeah, man. Where's the clips? I know that you're in there. I know you're in there somewhere. Well, that was easy. So what do we got in here? First of all, the incoming AC line, the ground goes straight to the ground bus. That's good. And then another ground goes from there off to this board, along with the black and white wires. So that will be probably the filtering and protection board, I'm guessing. Nice thick tracks over there anyway. And then some nice isolation slots all over the place. That's good too. Okay, that's cool. And then over here, so it connects to the hot and neutral buses as well. And that goes into the 5-volt output. So that will be the USB power supply board. Cool. Oh yeah, and way down in there, there's a little LED board for the two indicators on the front. For anyone interested in tearing one of these things apart, looks like there's 1, 2, 3, 4 clips around the sides that, how are they held together? It looks like you have to pop them off inwards, kinda. Except for I seem to have, done it the violent way and possibly broken something. Oh well, it's got screws. Speaking of which, let's take this power protection surge suppressor kind of board out of here and see what it has to say for itself. Really short wires. I'm going to take the LED board off too, just to make this easier on myself. Two little rectangular LEDs. You don't see those so much these days. I mean, they go into some special displays and stuff, but a lot of times things will use light pipes instead of just using the rectangular LEDs. That's kind of cool. So after taking a look at this board a little bit, this capacitor over here, which I can't read, is part of a capacitive dropper. It's in series. It provides a little power supply along here. This transistor down here is connected up to the surge suppression active LED, or the surge suppression, what does it call it? Surge protection okay? Protection active. That's what it's called. LED. We got two thermal cutouts here taped onto the side of this big ceramic block. And this ceramic block is, as far as I can tell, I haven't been able to find a data sheet, but I've found a few references to the part number, which is, for those playing along at home, 20S201X3. Now, initially, when I saw that X3, I thought it was an X3 class capacitor. Nope, nope, nope. This is a ceramic encased dual, I think, MOV. There are four terminals on the bottom of it here. It's a four terminal device, 1, 2, 3, 4. This is the neutral in and out. This is the line out, the line in, hot, I guess, if you will. And this is the ground over here. So this one is connected to the incoming line. These two are connected together and go into through one of the fuses. Okay, so I think it's either a 2 or a 3 MOV package. Could be either, it's hard to tell, although these two are wired together, so maybe, I don't know, not entirely sure. And like I said, I couldn't find any data sheets or anything on this guy, just a few references to it, so I'm kind of guessing there. But regardless, this is the protection board entirely, and as far as we can tell, it's still working if we can trust that little transistor circuit. So now let's pop out this power supply, this little 5-volt board here. What do we have here? So as I said before, it's just tied onto the bus bars of the hot and neutral over there. It's got a diode bridge hiding underneath that capacitor there. It's got a 250 volt 1 amp fuse there. A couple of capacitors. What are you guys? You guys are obscured. Oh, they're inductors. Underneath there it says L1. So those two guys are just inductors for filtering. Another capacitor. Chip. Can I read it? Looks like there's a bit of writing on there, but I can't read it. I think it's been obscured. I'm going to try getting my skull in there and see if I can read it properly and see if I can look it up. But we know what it's going to be anyway. It'll be just a standard little 8-pin power supply chip, switch mode power supply. It will chop up the voltage. It will send it through the transformer. Outside the transformer, it will be rectified by this generous little diode here and then smoothed by these two capacitors. And on the back of the board, underneath the transformer, some holes for ventilation and a nice big gap to keep the primary and secondary side comfortably separated. That's nice. So here is the positive and negative output rails. We have a couple of resistors just to load it down, a tiny little capacitor. There's the two big electrolytic capacitors there, another little capacitor, and we have a Schottky diode just for reverse voltage protection. Oh yeah, and a little spark gap there, just for added extra protection. Although if you got a voltage big enough to break over that spark gap, you're in real trouble. Also note inside here, all of the wiring that goes to and from anything is double insulated. It's got its own normal insulation. You can see the white one there. And then it's covered in loose heat shrink. Same with the two 5-volt outputs over here going to the USB connector board. All double sheathed just to keep everything nice and safe. This design seems to be pretty well thought out. There's a lot of good stuff going on in here. I like it. And I don't see any sparky damage or anything else in it, so I'm assuming that the reason that the old lady that was selling this at her yard sale sold it was just because it was surplus to needs, not that there was anything really wrong with it. And that is excellent. I think I am very comfortable using this, even though it's secondhand and doesn't have any provenance. Now, as usual, the hard part is getting everything put back together after a teardown. Fortunately, I don't think I damaged anything except for maybe a few of those clips that hold the cover on. This is going to be a pain, isn't it? Trying to get this guy back in deep down in that well where I can't get my mitts. That ain't right. I'll be back in a minute. Well, I think that is an excellent thing, especially for the 75 cents I paid for it. But even at full price, it's a fairly quality looking product. I am quite pleased with that. And if you have any information about that mystery ceramic block guy in there, let me know down in the comments. As I said, I assume that it is a multiple MOV package in a ceramic block. I did find an article from Tom's Hardware that tore down a different brand of power strip with suppression, and it had a very similar looking thing in it, but they couldn't find a data sheet on it either. And I mean, they've got an entire staff to look. I'm just one guy in his basement, but if they couldn't find it, I couldn't find it. It's probably not available to the general public, so we'll just go with that. So, what else is there to say? It's a good thing. I like it. I'm glad I got it. Thanks for watching. As always, I appreciate that. Questions and comments down below in the comments section. As usual, you guys know what you're doing. You've been on YouTube long enough. Thanks for watching. I'll talk to you later.